Hello everyone, here we talk about equivalent interest rate. We mentioned this concept before. If two different interest rates accumulate the same present value over the same time period to the same future value, the two interest rates are called equivalent. For the two equivalent interest rates, if one of the interest rates is compounded annually, it is called effective interest rate. If the other interest is compounded m times per year, then they have relationship as below. F is the effective interest rate. I is periodic interest rate for the interest compounding m times a year. We are going to use this idea to practice some examples here. Example 1. Assume you are given a choice of a term deposit paying 7.2% compounded monthly or an investment certificate paying 7.25% compounded semi-annually. Which rate offers the higher rate of return? We can simply compare the effective rate of interest, since effective interest rate compounded annually. For each interest rate situation, we switch them to corresponding effective interest rate. 7.2% compounded monthly, we can find out corresponding effective interest rate F1 0.074424. For 7.25% compounded semi-annually, we also can find corresponding effective interest rate F2 0.073814. So here we can clearly see the difference. F1 is bigger than F2. F1 is equivalent to 7.2% compounded monthly. F2 is equivalent to 7.25% compounded semi-annually. So they offer 7.2% compounded monthly is better. Example 2. Ariel has $1,000 to invest and must make a choice between 3.6% compounded monthly and 3.6% compounded semi-annually. Which investment is better and by how much? Obviously, we can see 3.6% compounded monthly is better, since the same number, if compounding more frequently, the money goes faster. Now we just try to find out by how much better. We can simply compare the future value after 1 year to see the difference. If the interest compounded monthly, after 1 year, we get future value $1,036.60. If the interest compounded semi-annually, after 1 year, we get future value $1,036.32. So the difference is 28 cents. That tells us how much better. Example 3. Determine the effective rate of interest corresponding to 9% compounded. Four situation: annually, semi-annually, quarterly, monthly. We find effective interest rate for each situation. First one, we don't actually need to calculate, since it is compounded annually, so 9% itself is effective interest rate. Even if we plug in the formula, we come out same answer. Second, 9% compounded semi-annually, the effective interest rate is 9.2025%. If 9% compounded quarterly, the effective interest rate is 9.3083%. If 9% compounded monthly, the effective interest rate is 9.3807%. So we can see that clearly, the effective interest rate increase little by little by the compounding situation more frequently. Example 4. You have money to invest in interest earning deposit. Deposits at your bank paying 3.5 compounded semi-annually. Deposit at a local trust company paying 3.625% compounded annually. And deposits at a credit union paying 3.45 compounded monthly. Which institution offers the best rate interest for your deposit? Again, we can compare the effective rate of all these three situations. In bank, the effective interest rate after calculation we get 3.5306. In local trust company, we do not have to do any calculation. The interest rate is compounded annually already. In credit union, we finish this calculation. We have effective interest rate 3.5051%. And we can see 3.625% compounded annually from local trust is the best offer. Example 5. Find the future value after 1 year of a debt of $100. Accumulate at, here we go, 12.55% compounded annually, 12.18% compounded semi-annually, 12% compounded quarterly, 11.88% compounded monthly. We simply calculate future value for each condition. Use future value formula, put all the information in properly. We finish the calculation. For all the four situations, we come out same answer, $112.55. That's the case we clearly see. 1, 2, 3, 4, these four different interest rate compounding different way, but they are equivalent. Example 6. Find the nominal annual rate compounded semi-annually. That is equivalent to an annual rate of 6% compounded annually. We can use a $1 present value for convenience to get future value in 1 year. If they are equivalent, they get the same future value after 1 year, they will get same future value after 2 years, so it doesn't matter, we take the convenience situation. For the nominal annual rate compounded semi-annually, the periodic interest rate, I, we do not know yet. We leave it there. For 1 year, two compounding period. So that's the future value for first part. Should be equal to another situation, 6% compounded annually for 1 year. So that's our equation. By solving this equation, we move the one, do some equivalent move, and we can get periodic interest rate I, 2.9563%. This is not our nominal annual interest rate yet. We need to multiply 2, get 5.9126%. That is the nominal annual interest rate, what we're looking for. Example 7. What nominal annual rate compounded quarterly is equivalent to 8.4% compounded monthly? Here again, if we use $1 PV as a present value, here again, if we use $1 as a present value to get the future value in 1 year, we can set up this equation easily. For the nominal annual rate compounded quarterly, periodic interest rate I, we don't know yet. That's the information we're looking for. Future value for this part, which is 4 compounding period, left side. For 8.4% compounded monthly, periodic interest rate divided by 12 for 1 year, 12 compounding period. That is future value, right side. They should be equal. Then we do the equivalent move. Both sides do the fourth root so we can isolate I. And then we move one to the other side, we solve I, 0.021147. And then we need to multiply 4, since this interest compounded quarterly, to get nominal annual interest rate, 8.4589%. We can have different perspective, different approach. Since these two interest rates are equivalent, so we can find effective interest rate separately for both of them. If they are equivalent, they should have same effective interest rate. When we put in formula, we can see F is the one being a bridge. Connect them together. They have the same effective interest rate. So we can set up this equation. And you can see this equation exactly same as the equation we assumed $1 present value. Example 8. Royce Bank currently offers 2.4% compounded semi-annually on premium savings deposit. His friend has told him that he would earn more interest if his saving compounded more frequently. What is the nominal annual rate compounded monthly that would be equivalent to his semi-annual rate? Similar situation. If we use $1 as present value and we look at future value in 1 year and set up equation. For 2.4% compounded semi-annually, $1 will raise future value after 1 year on the right side. For the nominal annual rate compounded monthly, the periodic interest rate I we don't know yet, showing on left side, that is $1 after 1 year, how much it get at the end. They should be equal. So we have the equation set up. Both sides do the twice root. When you try to solve equation, you always do exactly same operations on both sides. So you don't break this equation. That's called the equivalent move. So your equation still keep equation. So we can get I being isolated. Solve I, turn out the answer 0.1990%. And then we need multiply by 12. Multiply by 12 give us 2.3881%. That's the annual interest rate what we're looking for. Again, we can also use effective interest rate formula to set up bridge and to connect them together. We get exactly the same equation. You should try some exercise to get used to this idea. Practice is important. See you next time.